listening to Accent on TV, best of Poland and Europe, right here on LA Talk Radio.
Hey, I cannot say anything more than we have full house today.
It is
Accent
a full house.
On TV, the best of Poland and Europe, and whole world is in the studio. What a special show we have today. Not only I have with me my real great friend, Jeff Flora. Hi, Jeff.
How are you doing? Thanks for having me on the show.
How could I not? I think you will be stealing my own show today and my co-host show also, Marek Bacik.
That's all right, we let him.
You know, you have your own wonderful friends with us, and I ask you, can you bring some great artists? And you said, of course, and you chose them. And I am so proud that we'll be listening not only to live music played by you, but also our great new friends to the show.
These are two accomplished musicians, very good musicians, and I'm proud to know them. They're great.
And we had a chance to meet each other like 6 months ago, and I am so proud to have right now this one on a camera show, and now we can not only listen to them, but we can see them. Exciting. Okay, introduction. What is your name?
My name is Liza Carbe.
Liza Carbe, very accented name. Where are you originally from?
Well, I'm originally from Connecticut, but my father's from Sicily.
Oh, okay.
Oh, people.
Watch out. We're really nice to everybody.
She's Sicilian.
Yeah. Hey, we know
we
your father.
We need to behave.
Keep it like it is.
Okay, godfather's in the house. Okay, now we have another wonderful, very handsome gentleman. Okay, your name is?
My name is Jean-Pierre Durand.
Oh, whoa. My gosh, it sounds so sexy.
Man.
You need to repeat one more time.
Go ahead.
Jean-Pierre.
Yeah.
Let me do it better.
Yeah.
Okay, please.
Jean-Pierre Durand.
Whoa.
Oh, and everybody ask you right away, Jean-Pierre. You got some great roots. I'm from Poland originally. You are half Polish too, yes?
I have some. I'm a mutt. I have a little bit of everything. I have some Italian blood in me.
Oh.
Calabrese. I'm neighbors.
Oh, there you
now
go.
Now we have Sicilian and we have Jean-Pierre.
Peruvian.
Oh, beautiful. And of course, the instrument that you'll be playing. Is this only... Are you playing on the guitar or are you playing different instruments too?
We're both playing guitars today, yes.
Today, that's what I say. But if not guitar...
Typically, she'll play a lot of bass with the full band, and then we program synths and have a band called Incendio that we tour around the country with. We're also part of a duo called Carbe Durand, and we have 8 CDs out internationally. We perform all over the place, and Jeff and I have been friends since I was in the 5th grade.
Yes.
Aww. Oh, so that was like 5 years ago.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. The studio is very good.
Yeah.
Marek is my new friend.
That's your new friend.
I read
the same sandbox.
Your bio. I know that you both are working from 1996, yes, to get 1995.
Wow. Yeah.
That's a long, beautiful relationship.
Well, Lisa, I just want to interject. Lisa, as a bass player, has been a session bass. I've done work with her, too. But she toured with Lindsey Buckingham.
Wow.
And she's done a lot of studio work. So, and both of them, too, besides playing guitar... They've done composing for television and all sorts of media. So they're more than just guitar players.
And we have them live in our studio.
I'm
yes,
just
Marek?
Jealous that he's got hair like this. Look at this.
I mean,
holy moly.
And there are not extensions.
You know what's great? I can always hide a sandwich in
here. Yeah, that's right. Go, hey!
Okay, we have also in our studio
beautiful
girl, beautiful singer.
Stop talking about me like this.
Today, like everybody sees, is a very busy show. I had Violet 1 hour ago on Accent on Radio, and we were playing 3 of her songs, and then I would like to say hi to you, Violet.
Hi, thank you for having me.
Of course, she's from Poland. Tall, beautiful girl, singer, and for 1 year? One year ago you came to LA, yes?
I've been in LA for 1 year. I used to live in Florida.
And I know you are dreaming a big, yes?
Definitely. you have to dream big.
And you play hard and you are stubborn.
Yes, that's
and
correct.
I love it. And everything.
You have to do it.
And you are very smart, of course, because you're also a businesswoman. You have your own company
that
and you are
correct.
Here not only dreaming, but you are supporting your dream by working.
With 2 sisters.
And yes, that's very exciting. You have also 2 sisters, and I understand one is a model, almost 6 feet tall.
That's correct.
Yes, and her name's Angel.
Correct, yes.
And one more sister who is more into businesswoman.
She
and keeps
medical.
All 3 sisters together, and her name is?
Anna.
Anna, and you are again a singer. Mm-hmm. I cannot wait for everybody to hear a little your voice. If you feel like you have a courage, you can sing something tiny live, like 30 seconds, and I will fade you out like that, because we don't have a backing track for you. If you want to sing live, show us your voice for a little bit, then you can
just
do it.
Just give us the key.
That's right.
Okay.
We'll wing it.
And
because
the song.
Do you want to do
and
something?
The song, right. We can and the song. We can
do you think you can sing like 20 seconds of anything? Okay. This is tough. She's got no instrument right now. And I really put her on the spot because she didn't know. But you can say no, because, you know, I know it's not comfortable. But if you want, because you have beautiful, very deep, gorgeous voice. And if you have like 3-4 lines of something that you think pops up on your, could be cover, could be anything. Okay, just give it us.
I don't think that's the girl who should
Marek,
say
no.
No
singing.
I never say no.
That's right. That's what I'm saying.
Okay, let's give us something.
Looking out on the morning rain, I used to feel so uninspired. And then I knew I had to face another day. Lord, it made me feel so tired.
Woo! Awesome!
That's really, really beautifully. I'm thinking, Janis Joplin, yes, last week you had a manager of Janis Joplin. She could do some tunes from her. But you, what singers do you like the most? And you try to...
Just Stone. She's
okay.
The main one.
Okay, we'll let you be who you want to be. And I promise the three sisters will appear on our show, The Best of Poland, because we want to see all the gorgeous girls. And we'll talk more about music. Thank you. Marek Bacik, co-host also. Welcome to the show. Jeff. In a way, this is your show.
Right now, yeah, you took over.
You
took over the Polish people.
You can talk, all of you.
I was over next door, and I'm invading.
That's right. You know, we got experience with invading, so
in Poland,
watch
out. Everybody invited Poland, but special our friends, please take over. Let's talk about music and guitars, okay? I see you have very beautiful.
She asked me to come down and play today, so I brought this guitar down. I use it a lot for sessions. I usually don't bring it out. It's a 1920 parlor guitar. Oh. It's a Washburn.
1920. Oh, old baby.
And it actually was made by Lyon and Healy. And Lyon Healy's most famous for making chromatic harps, orchestral harps.
Wow. So
Jeff, I know you are talking, and you'll be talking a little bit more probably about your guitar, but you have your own show here on the radio. I think people need to know that hour after the show, when they switch to channel one,
it's on the same channel as yours, and it's called All About Guitar, and it's all about guitar.
Wow. Yes, and it's amazing, because guests that you are bringing to the studio, they're sometimes just out of this world. They are the best.
Thank you. No, we're trying to bring, and also I'm not always just bringing, the whole thing with the show is stuff, about, you know, obviously guitars, but some things like the guest last week who was a manager, that you need to know, but it's not necessarily strictly guitar-oriented stuff.
Right.
You have human stories. I was on your show, too. We are talking about a woman in business.
Women in music, yes.
In music, then. Yes, but again, I am sometimes jealous because the names of the people that are passing your studio, it's like, wow, he knows that. Oh, my gosh, a great
artist.
Sometimes
I see her dancing when she's leaving.
Right. We'll just like,
yes, I like that. Okay, Jeff, if people want to know something about you outside of that you have great show for like 2 years right now,
I had another show with my partner, Scott Sill. We did a show called The Flow Guitar Enthusiast, and that's when I first met you. And we did that for 2 years, and now I'm on my own. Scott had moved out of the state.
Yeah.
So I'm on my own now doing All About Guitar.
All by myself.
Yeah.
I wanna
you
be.
That's
a good song.
Right.
This doesn't
feel
sound
by
so
yourself?
Sad, even the song is sad. Yeah. But I think you're doing a pretty good job. And I see sometimes you are Skyping, you have video set up, and we see your friend's face. Also,
I haven't done as much video as we
anymore,
did before.
Yeah.
Scott was the one that. He had the GoPro, and he would stick the camera everywhere. But I do take pictures behind the scenes.
And if people want to see your show and your guest, please, can you tell us one more time name of your show?
It's Jeff Floro, All About Guitar. We're on Facebook. We're on Twitter at JFlo About Guitar. And also here on LA Talk Radio, just look on the schedule for Channel 1. And just past it, look for Accent On. Everybody knows where that is. Just go down a couple steps, and you'll see ours, and you can get all the shows.
Awesome.
Beautifully. I will let you talk about this beautiful 1920 guitar that you hold in your hands. You mentioned, how long do you have this guitar? How did you purchase?
I've had it for a while, but it wasn't playable. And I got it from a friend of mine had called me up and said, there's this guy, he's got this stuff, you might want to check this out. And he goes, I want the Martin. He had an old Martin guitar, yeah, which are worth a lot of money. So I said, yeah, I'll come down there. But he said, the Martin's mine. Okay, no problem. So I went down there, and this old man, he was my friend's barber. And he had these guitars for about 50 years. They were his son's, and his son had passed away. Wow. And he said, I have no need for them. Just, you know, you guys play music. I just want to give them, take them and use them, you know.
Oh, that's nice.
So when I got this guitar, the neck was really bowed. It was pretty bad. So I couldn't play it for a while. And so I just kept it. But I got some other interesting stuff from him. I got a banjo mandolin that was engraved, a couple of mandolins that had like abalone pearl all over them, really beautiful.
Beautiful.
And these were old, really old instruments, and a violin. And so I held on to this thing, and I've been waiting for a while to figure out who to take it to. And then about 5 or 6 years ago, I had a guy, Andy Brower, took it, and we reset the neck. Because a lot of people wanted to rebuild the whole neck. And the inlay, you can't see it on the camera, but there's some really intricate little flower inlays on it.
Oh, okay.
And so I was nervous about them tearing up the fretboard and redoing it. So he was one of the few guys that said that he could preserve the board.
Wow.
So they reset the neck. I lost one inlay right here, but it's okay. It's pretty close. But the guitar plays great. It's a really, for such a small body, it's a pretty loud guitar.
I know you'll be playing for us live, and we'll listen to the tonality of you playing and the guitar. I'm also hoping that people can see you because you are far away, and I hope camera. Yes,
we'll
you are not the enigma. Jeff is really
here. But see, I don't want to cross her.
No, I'm all the time here.
She'll be here next week.
But I really want your guitar to be heard and seen. Would you like to play something for us right now?
I'm going
to
do
can we make this easy for you? Because, yes.
I got to kind
of. Okay, don't worry about me.
How about you just massage him when he sings?
Yeah.
This is a song by Justin Hayward of the Moody Blues, who's a big influence for me. It's an interesting little song. It's kind of a folk style. And hopefully I will sing it properly.
Oh,
it's my debut singing. I haven't been singing.
Oh, whoa!
We have a guest.
Like the crashing of a wave on the shores of consciousness, we're alive and awake to the world. With the gift of love, we're blessed, 'cause we can be, yes, we can be, we could be children.
Harmonize this one, I think, on the wind.
In the twinkling of an eye, or a turning of a page, comes a moment when our time has arrived. We can never be the same, 'cause we could be, yes, we. Violence and the rain.
again.
That's so sweet, so beautiful, so calming.
It's a great little song. I'm a big fan of Justin Hayward.
Oh, that's awesome. thank you so much. Wow, but I feel this part of the table will make us a little dance, little move.
I refuse to follow
I feel
that.
Energy you refuse. Is coming from this
We're
item.
Leaving.
Okay. Oh, Ilona's getting violent here.
That was lovely.
The table is shaking. Okay, let's talk about a beautiful, beautiful artist here. What will be playing? What will be listening to?
Barcelona.
Oh my God,
whoa.
That's great.
Barcelona is an Incendio song written by our friend, our third member who is not here, Jim Stubblefield. And this is usually like a second set opener. We'll do it. We'll try to take you to Barcelona.
Oh, right.
Never been there.
Maybe Warsaw.
There you go.
Perhaps Krakow.
Barcelona.
Close.
Barcelona. We go Barcelona.
With Ilona and our friends. Okay.
Puts a different twist on it.
That's right.
All right.
Barcelona song.
Beautifully, beautifully.
It's not Krakow, but it will do.
No,
it was
Krakow
Barcelona,
is Barcelona.
So we're close to it.
Beautiful Spain. Okay. I would like to learn a little bit obvious about both of you, because every artist has a journey, you know, that get us to this point. And you are from Kentucky, obvious, but you are from your parents,
Connecticut. Close.
But you are from LA, yes? You were raised here?
Pretty much. I was born in Connecticut, and I lived there when I was little. My father was an artist, and we came back out here because he worked in the studios. So I've grown up in Los Angeles.
Recording artist also, yes?
And, he was a musician and an artist, but he made his living, as an artist. So I've always played music. I started singing when I was little and started taking guitar lessons when I was 9. And there was always music in the house, so my parents encouraged me to do music. And
it just seemed like a natural progression.
Wow. So. And this is all what you're doing. You're doing all your life. You never really escape from the dream to become a musician. And that's all what you do? Or you have another?
No, that's it. I mean, we write, we play music, and we do a lot of writing. We started writing. The first placement I got was probably in the 80s when I was with Vixen. I'd written a song with them, and that got in a movie. And then as things moved, I was working with a lot of other musicians and producers and just started seeing, you know, really the way, the longevity in this business was to be a writer and a producer. So I was slowly working towards that.
They work as producers. They've produced other artists. So not just themselves in Incendio. Yeah. They actually do produce other artists.
Yeah, because, you know, when you are in LA and you dream of us, not only become musician but stay and work and earn money and living to be a musician, a lot of people really, they somehow go left of it. They just one day decide, I don't think so, I can survive in this business and work in this business. Then do you believe talent, a lot of people have amazing talents, but do you think that perseverance and being stubborn and really dream all your life and hard work, that's your success story?
Yes, certainly perseverance and certainly studying and trying to make intelligent choices.
Yeah. Intelligent, I like that, you know, because life has a lot of choices and some of them are maybe more excited than others, but you need to choose what is right for you. And in 1995, somehow, I would like to know how you both met, because now it's 2016, you know, it's a really long time for friendship, relationship like that, and you both are continue working together. Beautiful.
One thing I wanted to say is that I think I've been lucky enough to really get some wonderful gigs as well. That, you know, whenever I might think of like, oh my God, what am I going to do now? Yes. A great gig would come along, you know, being able to play with Lindsey Buckingham for two years was amazing.
That's amazing.
And that's when I met JP. He had a Steely Dan cover band.
Whoa,
so
JP.
He needed a bass player, and that's how I met him.
I think the most important thing, stubbornness is good, determination, let's call that determination.
Right.
Yes.
Education is paramount, self-education, because if, Violet, you are able to make the right connections and establish right things, and you are offered a set of things, and it's A, B, and C, the only thing that distinguishes you from a lot of other people is your ability to decide which of those three is the most important thing, because it might be a manager and they might be, not the best idea for you to go to. It might be a deal that it's better to pass on. A lot of times it's a deal that everybody's telling you to pass on that you take, that maybe is a little less money. It's all, so it's very difficult to rely on the counsel of others. I think that's you need to have that trust at some point. But the most important thing I think that Lisa and I have with each other is a trust that we will generally try to move forward in the right decision. We have stuff that we, you know, bounce off our other member, and he makes informed decisions too. So that, I think, is the absolutely most important thing.
But that's the intelligent choices. Mm-hmm. Like you say, sometimes you go against what people say, but you think is right for you. You take less money, maybe, or in funky places. But for whatever reason, that's the right choice. I'm developing a lot of artists, and I always bring them to studio, and they're young people, and they are looking at me, and I'm an unusual human being because I'm from Poland, and I'm surviving exclusively of music business and paying my bills. And sometimes even strangers who are in this business say, how do you do that? And I say the same. You never give up. You are persistent. You try to make intelligent choices. Sometimes you back off, you know, but I don't believe in forgetting why you love music so much. And I think all of us live and breathe music, except Marek.
I just breathe money.
You breathe money.
I kind of wheeze.
Oh, yeah. That's what I breathe.
I kind of wheeze music.
Yeah.
And I sometimes feeling guilty because my daughter finished the music business at USC, and now is like, is this what you will be doing whole life, fighting in a music business for your place or field?
Well, everything is changing so much, you know, as long as she stays aware of how things are evolving. And how, you know, if she's real, you know, she's kind of young, she has still has time to choose a lane. Eventually, and I mean, even our guest later has talked about is a picking. Eventually, you have to pick a lane, and you have to make that choice. I will say that Jeff is the first person I met. I was going to St. Paul the Apostle in Westwood, and he was coming and doing shows for liturgy and shows and performing for liturgies and performing for graduations, those kind of things. And he was the first person that I saw that was fully had the passion, was a musician's musician, understood how to play parts, and understood also that there are not just sharing the wealth, which he was very generous to do with me at an early age, but also being aware that there are political situations that you walk into in any gig that you walk into, and I watched him navigate those and learn from those things.
We can learn a lot from Jeff.
Yeah,
we can
learn how to yell and scream.
That's right. That's right.
And then, the same thing with her. And I would hope that it's a mutual reinforcement educational thing all the time.
Well, we're both Italian, so we yell and scream.
Yeah, that's a usual. That's a usual.
Most importantly, we use hands. But I want to interject one thing. There's a story I want Lisa to tell you that I just think is probably the coolest thing I've ever heard. And she did a solo album, and she wrote this song, and tell them who responded and sent you an email.
Oh.
I'm trying to keep it.
So okay, I was like, which letter? Well, lots of them. Okay.
What story?
Well, my mother was always an Anglophile. So her family came from England, and she really stuck with that theme. And she still loved the Queen. She still loved everything about England. So she kept a picture of the Queen always in her room.
Okay.
And so when I wrote a song about her called She Still Loves the Queen, when she passed, I sent a copy of the CD and a letter to the Queen and told her the story.
How did you know address? I'm joking.
The palace.
Buckingham
Palace, England.
Well, actually, and more of the story was that this descendant that came from England was a lady in waiting to Queen Victoria. So she got with the gamekeeper, and that wasn't good. So they escaped to Scotland and then came to America. So I wrote and told her the story. And she wrote back, well, one of her lady-in-waitings wrote back and said, thanked me and said that the Queen thanked me for the lovely story and for my good wishes towards her. Wow. And sent me a personal letter. I was so thrilled. Whoa. So it's framed. And
Jeff,
she's got a copy of my CD.
Story.
It was wonderful.
Do?
Yeah.
Wow.
Oh,
yeah,
congratulations. See? And again, that's great because not only you wrote this song, but you put this step, forward, and you send your song things imaginable that is impossible that Queen can write you back. Like that happen, and that's what is entertainment business. You just never know who will respond and why they respond. If you hit their nerves or their heart, and that's what music is about. And mentioning that you both know each other so many years too, and the friendship is so beautiful and close for so many years. I just love that story. I think music business, entertainment business is a really good one. Good business
there
to
are
be
good,
in.
Very, very good people.
A lot of great people. We hear about funky people that make maybe this business murky, but most of people are just hardworking, beautiful human beings, okay? And I really, really think it's time for another beautiful song.
I just want to say, because Queen Write Me Back too, but the address was in West Hollywood. So I don't know.
Different Queen.
The only letter I got.
Yeah, so I have no idea what kind of Queen was that, but hey.
The only letter I ever got was from Guido, and he's always going to break my
hand. Yeah, no queens, no, different letters. So just want to share my story.
Also, when it comes to letters and being a stubborn perseverance, you can tell how you got your coach, which you had a good story too. You wanted a certain coach and a vocal coach, and you just got him because you were stubborn and you tell us fast. There was writing involved?
Yes.
Yes? Who is this gentleman?
Stevie Mackey.
Okay, and he's a coach, vocal coach to the biggest singers, yes?
Oh, yes, like Jennifer Lopez, Justin Bieber, Selena Gomez, JoJo. So finally I got him, and now we're best friends. Yeah,
In a way, he's teaching you soul music. You are working more about your vocal to
soul,
become...
Soul, toy soul,
But names that you are picking up, who represent...
He doesn't teach only soul singers. He teaches also the pop singers.
I think he just got excited hearing your voice because it's a pretty cool one. And
I know, I am super excited to have
But yeah, it was how many emails took you before?
Oh my gosh, 4 or 5.
And he said, okay, now I'm in LA. And then he said, Thursday,
Thursday, I remember the Thursday.
And you just come and you got and you are practicing a year later. I think you are very happy with teacher, beautiful teacher. You know, we
absolutely
all had great teachers and we need to study. Okay, what we'll be listening right now.
Cool. Very cool. Light dancer. Is a dog? Isn't Olsen a big dog person? A big animal?
Susan Olsen.
Yeah, one
Susan,
of your.
I mean, yeah.
So.
Oh we'll yeah,
send
yeah.
A she's a bass player too. Most yes. Most important.
So we'll send a shout out to another LA Talk Radio host.
Oh, there you go.
Hi, Susan. We love you.
Actually, she'll be on. I think next hour. She's on Two Chicks Talking Politics.
This
okay,
is
we'll
a. This is a song
her.
About our Rottweiler. We're gonna do the full length. The full length version of this one. This is called a Light Dancer.
I love it. I hear almost song with lyrics there. That's very unusual inspiration.
And go on the on YouTube. They did a video of that, and a lot of their fans, including myself, we sent pictures of our dogs, and they have all the dogs.
Really? Wow.
Party yeah. Dog party.
Yeah. Awesome.
I smell very cool video.
I smell awesome. Business here. Yeah. You need to go to Facebook and find out who has... dogs and start offering maybe songs for dogs.
That's a great
everybody
idea.
I would like
jewelry,
song for my
well.
Porsche
yeah.
for my dog
get
she's
a little iPod.
Just very romantic
Porsche
That's her name. Yes, she's very fast.
Perfect.
She's a Porsche.
She's very fast.
A very fast dog, and really we decided fast. That
you go. You open the door, she's gone.
She's gone.
No.
It's a Porsche.
You are right. They have their characters, and I think that's a beautiful story. Okay, do you want a song? $5,000 for your dog, and then you could do a CD, and then everybody's buying anyway. No, it's a beautiful, beautiful idea. So hi, Susan. We love your dog.
I would massage the dog.
But he's big one, yes?
Yes.
She was.
Did you have a chance to meet the dog?
Their song
was about their dog.
Yeah, about right. You have still
about
your dog.
About our second Rottweiler, we're on our third.
Okay. Yeah. That big one, a scary one. Everybody's scared of Rottweiler.
Not really. No? It's supposed to be nice, dog.
So because the music that you play is so gentle.
My friend just
got
a Rottweiler and she passed away, but it was the sweetest dog ever.
The reason we called it Light Dancer is she used to chase the little reflections
like
of light.
Cat.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Like 110 pounds.
Rottweilers are really nice.
That's what is amazing. I try to imagine this big dog. I mean, to the gentle
they're
music.
They're big dogs, but then nice dogs.
No, when the dog comes in and you hear the music from the Omen, then you kind of get nervous.
I know.
Oh, wait a minute.
Okay.
No, they're lovely. They have a lot of different animals. They have great. They have birds, everything.
Yeah, really? Wow.
You do. Yeah, we've got 4 dogs and 2 parrots.
Wow. And a studio in home?
Yes.
Of course. Yes. And you were producing records for another artist?
We do. We produce for other artists, but we write a lot of production music. We write a lot of library music. So a lot of our music gets used in History of Mexico or Burn Notice or Breaking Bad or Star Trek, Bridesmaids, the movie The Secret.
We've got
lots and lots of placements.
Wow.
So
congratulations.
Going back to the stubbornness and the determination thing, another little story. So when we first got together and I was working in Spanish television and she wanted to very much move forward and we had just kind of funky equipment and it was good equipment but it was kind of not all connected. And we had the opportunity with some friends to do some music for Entertainment Tonight to at least audition for it. And I said, well, we're going to need, maybe this, and I'm not sure. And she grabbed me by the shirt and said, listen, somebody's going to do a really crappy demo on a little cassette recorder, and they're going to go for it, and they're going to get the gig. And I was like, okay, so just throw it, caution the winds, and just do it. Because, I was so in my head about trying to prepare for how to do it, it kind of left out the portion of actually doing it.
Yes.
And that was a tremendous object lesson. And that's lesson. And so you talk about the foundation of starting things. Sometimes you
just
need to
do it.
Throw yourself in.
Some people will work on one or two songs for a year and they still isn't perfect.
Yeah,
still isn't.
We got the gig and 300 minutes music later, we just kept writing and writing for it. And that was kind of kicked off our career as far as writers.
So then it was one ADAT, then there's two, then there's a little guitar preamp. Then, we just kept building little by little all of the pieces. And, that's the same way everybody starts, just to do it little by little.
And that was another thing I was going to say, is that so many people wait for someone else to do something for them, and you can't. And especially nowadays, you've got so much opportunity to do it all yourself. So you just can't wait for someone else. If they can't do it for you, then learn how to do it and just do it.
Yeah, and what we are learning in pop music, sometimes the best ballads are played acoustic and piano. Bruno Mars, and he plays beautiful piano, simple piano. Songs are great. And John Legend, also very simple arrangement. Sometimes you don't need a big production. You really need to be honest with what you want to play. But I'm so, in a beautiful way, jealous about your relationship, because it's just passion and it's got everything going on, dreams and hard work. And, of course, success story. We want success story. And you have personal success story also, which is beautiful. What about us, Jeff? Are we happy people?
Yes.
I'm happy. Jeff is happy.
Okay.
Yeah, Jeff is
that
happy.
Was
look
from
at
left,
Jeff.
Ilona,
someone's
right?
Happy.
Why are you asking me this question? I know you're happy because
in
10 minutes you'll be having your own show. Who is today on your show?
Our guest tonight is Steve Vai.
Oh, okay.
Okay. Could you tell us a little bit more about
He's one of the best guitarists I know of, and he's pretty much pioneered taken the guitar in many different directions that most people have never even thought of. So we're going to talk to him a little about that. But he also he's very much into education. We're going to talk about the schools that he set up called VI Academy. And he also, as a foundation, makeanoise.org.
Hmm.
Oh, that's awesome.
And basically gets musical instruments for kids that can't afford it.
Oh,
he is like
so
the Lech Walesa.
Like Valencia of guitar. There. That's right. That's right.
You really make my heart warm. How do you know so much about Poland?
That's the only name I have.
That's the right name.
Desperate, and what's his name? The soccer player, Lato.
Yeah.
Everybody.
I didn't know that guy.
Lech Valencia. My question is for you guys. Do you guys play for each other?
Oh, absolutely.
Like, hey, you know, I'm going to play you this song today.
Oh, absolutely.
The romantic moments?
We run stuff by each other constantly.
That's awesome.
Make sure.
Did you ever say, I hate this one?
Yeah.
Gets you nowhere, why you are doing... No.
Oh,
yes?
Yeah. Sometimes we play something, go, what do you think about this? And
one of us you have to be honest.
That's a bad idea.
Loving someone is being honest.
What are you thinking?
But he's always wrong.
What?
But he's always wrong.
Yeah, he is.
Yeah. And the funny thing, he admits it right away, yes.
We have this on a camera.
All at home,
She is Sicilian. There is no other option.
Yeah, that's right.
Gosh.
I'm going to send my dad. I get a shovel and a gun.
Dirt
map. Collection of knives.
That's right.
I want one more song. Sorry, we have three is the good one. Then we need a three.
Okay.
Two is not good enough.
Very kind of you.
We love to listen to the music.
Well, too bad we can't play something with you.
Yeah,
I was
trying to.
The next show. Next show is always the next one.
On that one that she was doing.
Oh,
right?
That would be so much fun.
What'd you doing in G? Weren't you doing in G?
Okay, that would be cool. We can create something right now.
You can create something right away.
Yes.
Right. There's nothing to lose.
Live jamming on Accent on TV, the best of Poland, Europe, and whole world. Music will be played, arranged as we speak.
Seriously?
Okay, my beautiful talent. Do we have a key?
If you want,
G?
Right?
That's fine.
Okay.
I think she's
Can try.
She's going to make it up and go on.
This is a great idea. You never wait. You just
take a second, get the lyrics. In the meantime, you got them? Okay.
That's cool.
We'll see how far we get.
Oh my gosh. Congratulations.
Woo. Should I be like here?
Yes, be close to the microphone. There it is. We have 2 minutes.
Looking out on the morning rain, I used to feel so uninspired, and then I knew I had to place another day. Lord, it made me feel so tired. Before the day I met you, life was so unkind, but you're the key to my peace of mind, 'cause you make me feel. You make me feel, 'cause you make me feel like a natural woman. When my soul was in the lost and found, you came along. I didn't know just what was wrong with me, till your kiss helped me found it. Now I'm no longer doubtful for what I'm living for. If I make you happy, I don't need to do it more. 'Cause you make me feel, 'cause you make me feel, 'cause you make
performance. Like you said, why to wait? That was very good and brave of you.
Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you so much. It was beautiful. Yeah. We have 5 more minutes. Song number 3.
Okay.
She tricked you into
it. Let's
so the name of a band is Make Love, Not Warsaw, right? Is that what
they're trying?
Make love, not war.
From the second verse of Jaco. Okay, this is for Jaco Pastorius and Paco de Lucia. This is called Jaco y Paco.
Oh my gosh! Okay, Paco de Lucia.
Second verse. One. From the top, and then the second verse. 3, 4. Sorry.
From the top.
That's a live TV. There you go.
1, 2, 3, and.
To dedicate the last beautiful song
to
your wife, Christine. I know she's watching.
Next to me, so she's not going on.
No, I know she will enjoy the show and she'll be watching. She said she'll be watching. That's so beautiful. This is
very talented people. Thank you guys
so talented.
Thank you
today.
Thank you
on our Action on TV, the best of Poland and Europe and the whole world. We had beautiful guest Jeff Floro.
Thank you for being.
Don't forget about me.
Okay, Ilona Europa.
This is Liza Carbe. I'm JP Durand. Please check us out at incendioband.com, also on facebook.com/incendioband. And next year we hope to be touring with Ilona and Marek through Poland with them showing us around. And Violet, what's your information? We'd love to come check you out and play.
How we can find Violet?
Instagram, Violet Oliferuk.
My last name is sad.
I know.
Or everybody goes to Accent On and just check links to your
Definitely.
Facebook page. The same. I post, of course, every information about both of you. Marek Bacik, thank you so, so much for joining me on thank today's you. Show. Until next Monday.
Thank
Jeff.
You.
Mwah! Thank you.
Thank you.
You're listening to Accent On TV. Best of Poland and Europe, right here on LA Talk Radio.